From a startup idea to selling a company to Cisco Systems at $3.7 billion, that's the journey that Jyoti Bansal, founder and former CEO of AppDynamics, has taken. Jyoti, thank you for speaking to us. It's been a super journey, you know, from a startup idea to $3.7 billion. And now you are also looking at other ideas, you know. So is this a journey that an entrepreneur takes, bring out a company, that you innovate, and then probably because you also wanted to survive in the longer run, you look at other larger players also who will come over and take over that company. Can you explain that journey of an entrepreneur?
In our case at AppDynamics, we're not looking to sell the company because you have to sell the company to a larger company. Mm. We were actually about to go public on Nasdaq. And just 2 days before our IPO, we had an acquisition offer from Cisco. And you know, we said no to the first offer, and they made a second offer, which we said no to, and they made a third offer, which from a shareholder perspective, that was the right thing to do because you know, it's that was the right value creation for all the different stakeholders, right? So it's many times it's not really like, you know, you design your company to sell. That's a very bad idea for anyone to ever do it.
Right.
And you design your company to be a great company, to a great business. And you know, and then different kind of liquidity events will happen when that, you know, if you have a great business. If you're a great business, a lot of people want to own your business.
Right.
You know, from a public market shareholders, from private shareholders, from, you know, other larger companies. And you know, if you think that's the right thing for your shareholders and stakeholders, you do that.
Right. Take us through to the journey that you undertook in the U.S. You know, you after your engineering degree, you went there. You were working on an H-1B visa, and you went through your own frustrations of probably, you know, not being able to incubate your own company as well. Take us through that journey, and how did finally the idea of AppDynamics came through?
Sure. So I graduated from IIT Delhi and went to US pretty much right after. And I was very fascinated by startups, so I wanted to work in startups. I wanted to create my own startups as well. And I was on a H-1B work visa. On H-1B, there are limitations on can you quit your job and start your own company.
Right.
So that was frustrating, you know, and a lot of people who are there on H-1B kind of go through that frustration. So there was a positive part of it that it forced me to work into startups and learn a lot. So you know, so that was for about, you know, 8 years or so. And in 8 years, I worked in three different startups, and I learned a lot because, you know, it's in startups you see, you learn a lot from failures, you know, sometimes more than success. Because of, and the three startups I worked in, you know, there were different degrees of failures and success, and you know, so by the time I was ready to do my own company, this was back in 2008. And you know, I even though I never ran a startup before, I knew a lot about them because I've seen them closely working in them.
Right. The media talks about the success stories, you know, very often. Don't talk about the failures. You know, can you please tell us what are the kind of failures that people face when they start up their own company, and the and the pain process that they undergo?
Sure. You know, that's a very good question. I would say about 9 out of 10 startups fail. And a lot of them fail at the very early stages, that they don't even get off the ground, and a lot of them fail at the kind of the mid to later stages as well, right? And failure is part of startups. Like it, that's the whole concept, that you go after solving a problem that is early. Like if it's a problem that everyone knows how to solve it, everyone knows it's even a problem.
Yeah.
Then it's probably too late,
right?
So you're taking a chance, you're taking a risk. And startups fail. So startups fail for two reasons. One is like, you know, you may just your idea, your concept may not be the right concept or the right timing or the, you know, and you're taking a chance on it and the chance didn't work, that's totally fine. The second reason startups fail is like you may have the right market and the right idea and the right concept, but you didn't execute on it properly. Because if you have the right idea, right concept, it there'll be other companies trying to execute on it also, right? So you have to compete, you have to execute on all fronts from, you know, from hiring to, you know, raising capital, building products, selling, scaling, all sort of different things, right?
Okay.
So failure is part of startups, and to me it's like, you know, people should talk about it also because you learn a lot. And in Silicon Valley especially, you know, the good thing about there is there's almost no stigma to to a failed startup.
Right.
Like almost everyone who works there, in their resume they are failed startups.
Yeah.
And to me, that's a great thing. Like once you remove the stigma, then people get more open to taking those chances.
Okay. On that note, what are you doing next? You know, what's your next big idea?
My next big idea is something called a startup studio. Mm. I call it big labs. So it's, right. You know, the idea is to the idea is to create big ideas, or and experiment with them. So what we do in big labs is we create a list of problems that we are excited about solving, you know, and then we go and build a team to solve, to try to experiment with those problems and see if they're interesting businesses to be built around those, and then we spin out those businesses out of the. You know, out of the lab. It's right. still very early. You know, we have launched our first company out of it, and our plan is to launch like, you know, one company maybe every 18 to 24 months.
Right.
That could be a potential next $1 billion company.
Right. And do you have many startup ideas coming from India? Well, how do you see the ecosystem here?
You know, I'm very excited about the Indian startup ecosystem. Mm. It's actually there's so many interesting ideas. I hear from a lot of entrepreneurs, and in this trip I'm doing in India, I'm spending a lot of time in a lot of different stakeholders in the startup ecosystem.
Mm.
I do think especially I'm personally excited about the B2B startups and the SaaS startups, and you know how I think we are at that tipping point that we will see many of those successful, potentially unicorn startups in the B2B space.
Right, Jyoti, pleasure speaking to you.
Okay, thank you.